I'm actually proud of Murtaugh here. That was a blade slicing. How's it going, YouTube lovers? This is the Gable Rammer. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm doing the reaction video. Today I'm reacting to Hello Neighbor, Welcome to Ravenbrook, Season 2, Episode 5, Deal with the Devil. Last time, Trinity started to see the consequences of her constantly pushing her friends to get into this mystery that she's obsessed with. Now, granted, yeah, she's being threatened by it too, but she was dragging her friends into it, and now all of them are gone. Everyone. And is forcing her into desperate action to go to Mr. Peterson himself for help. So I am very, very curious to see where we're going to go from here, because we are officially past the halfway point of the season. This is the second half, so if things are like the first half, it's going to start picking up now, and I'm excited to see where it's going to go. So I'm going to keep this intro short and jump right into this video. We can see what the deal with the devil the title is talking about is referring to. Ooh, we're starting without an intro. It was really good last time they did that. Hey, Delroy. Is he on the run? Yeah, there's Crowface. They've done such a great job of making Crowface legitimately threatening in this season. Like, I think he's my favorite part of the franchise at this point. That took a little bit for the music to kick in there. Ah, yes, back with Trinity.
Trinity Bale. Ravenbrook's best kid detective and future missing child.
Nice, Peterson.
Is that supposed to scare me? Because I found your book.
Then you're in even more danger. Give it to me.
Oh, why?
Want it back? Tell me who or what is after us.
Just explain it.
You enjoy spying on people, don't you? The intrusion. The thrill.
I mean, that's kind of the point of these
games. I'm not here to play games, weirdo.
I mean, different game.
I can see into your house from mine, you know. Watched your parents fight. Watched you do your homework.
That's...
Watched you.
That's... Yeah, that's creepy,
fine.
Dude.
Don't help. Enjoy rotting in here.
You won't just walk away. You can't. You're obsessed.
Exactly, yeah.
Just like you were in Shelbyville.
Oh, he actually knows about her. We don't even know all the details about her parents.
You're a little monster. Your parents know it. I know it. And soon everyone will.
What happened at the last place you lived, Trinity?
Who will they blame when your friends turn up dead?
Ooh.
Trinity.
Yeah, I mean...
And where are your
He does have
now?
A point. You have to give him credit. He has
know.
A point here.
We were ambushed.
Oh, there goes the phone. Oh, there was a Crowface driving it. Okay. Again, what happened to... that also Marissa was... encountered one too, so like, there's gotta be multiple Crowfaces. This has gotta be, like I said, a cult, basically. Okay, so Enzo 100% got captured. That is genuinely horrifying. Oh! That conveniently worked. Once again, you stumble your way through your problems, just like when you were in Peterson's house last season, Enzo. Okay, now that's just cheating. Again, this storm, the weather station is gonna come into play again. This storm has something to do with it.
School is my happy place. My happy place is school.
Oh
school
my gosh, Ivan. Yeah, 100%. There's. Either it's proper, like, supernatural teleportation, which it could be at this point, but I feel like it's more, there's multiple crow faces. Okay, now he just looks like Ghostface more than Crowface. But
ambushed?
I think it's more like the It's a, his cult, like
there's
I said.
A nasty little traitor in your ranks. A real rat.
Wait.
I wonder which one.
Are you just sowing chaos, or is this actually what's happening?
That timid little mouse of a boy, or the insect with the bat. Or maybe it's Nikki. Does he want to come back yet? Back home? I miss my boy.
Stop it!
That's just...
Your mind games won't
yeah, where is your actual son at this point, Peterson? Where's Aaron?
Who is Crowface? And how is this book connected to stuff?
It's a secret. Come close.
Oh my gosh, that's not going to work, Peterson. She already is...
Why is this book so dangerous?
Our masked guest is dead set on their life being magnificent. Ours being worse.
He even called him guest right there, just like in the games.
My life has been pretty miserable lately.
Someone has to suffer for someone else to soar.
So who in Ravenbrooks has been dealing out all this trouble?
Lots of us are hiding secrets here, aren't we?
You definitely get the sense that Ravenbrooks is a lot more hidden.
So it turns out, you're not the only one.
Not the only one.
Good for Delroy. It seems like he's been making a good run for it here. Okay, well... Whoa, wait a minute. They're actually... I was like, was that a second one that showed up to help, or... Oh, that's never good. Yeah, I knew it! I called it! Delroy? You okay, buddy? Yeah, it's just straight up there's multiples. This is his cult serving him. But there's also a lot more. That's like at least five. Like, if these are taking place at the same time, that's like at least five or more.
After hours, Ivan, you're not supposed to be here.
Do you see this, Murtaugh?
What are you doing here?
Is he actually going to be like a helpful guy here after he's been... He's protecting Ivan. He's been creepy this whole time. He's actually protecting him.
Stay back. These vials are filled with acid.
Hey, Ivan, were you so sure about Murtaugh being Crowface there? Oh, you're... Oh.
Run.
So it is, like, it's not one of everyone they suspected, because, like I said, the whole cult thing. It's everyone that they suspected.
You leave my student alone. If you think you can intimidate
I'm actually proud of Murtaugh here. That was a blade slicing. I wonder what condition he's going to be in next time we see him. Okay.
Your pursuers must not acquire my book.
So, burn it?
She's gonna...
Then you'll never know the truth. Will you?
What do you want?
I can see the goosebumps on your skin.
You're good at being creepy, but what do you actually...
I can handle this by myself.
That's what he wants. I was like, get to the point, Theodore.
We can only stop them if you let me out of here.
We?
You made yourself a part of this. Our fates are entwined now. You need my help. And
the realtor, hardware store clerk, they're dead because of you. No way I'm gonna...
How dare you? I didn't hurt those people.
Mm-hmm.
That was the nasty handiwork of our masked acquaintance.
Yeah, because like he...
So you're not...
He only just showed up at each of those.
What I am is tired of waiting. Get me out.
What you are is a man scared of losing the last part of his family.
This. Now let me finish
Whoa.
It.
Not sure I like seeing that much, that many of his teeth.
Take my hand, child.
Nah, Trinity, you're smarter than this.
Take it. Take my hand.
I'm good.
Take it, you sniveling pest.
Yeah, you're smarter than that, Trinity. Nicely done.
Take it. Take it.
All right. Okay, good to know that they actually didn't get captured. They were just running that entire time. Where's Maritza? She's the only one we haven't seen this whole time.
Maritza! Maritza!
Yeah, she's the only one. There she is.
Crowface, there's
why haven't we seen you the whole time?
I know. I saw them. We gotta tell Trinity. Come on. Trinity, you're okay. Enzo? I barely got away. There were so many of them.
Same, bruh. Exactly the same.
I'm so now, glad you're all okay.
Ivan?
How did they know where we'd all be?
They're everywhere. They probably know we're here right now.
I mean, it's literally everyone in town.
You guys weren't followed here, were you? I don't think so.
We weren't followed. What about Delroy?
Me? No.
Track team. Oh, hey, Nikki.
No.
You okay,
oh, track
buddy?
Team. That's how you outrun supernatural freaks. You sure?
I'm sure. Back off.
Don't tell me to back off. You back off.
Guys, this is not the time.
Hey, where's Ivan?
He was at the school. Same as Trinity.
Did you see where Ivan went, Trinity?
Hi, Nikki.
Trinity!
Ivan? Yeah, Crowface showed up at school. Or one of the Crowfaces, anyway. I had to run home. So I don't know where I...
You weren't here when I showed up.
Yeah, so...
Yeah, where'd you go before that?
Where were you?
Uh-huh.
I...
Talked to Peterson.
Mr. Murtaugh is dead!
Is he actually, or is this elaboration, like...
They killed him! They killed him!
I don't know what to trust to the show, if he's actually dead or not.
Guys,
he probably feels guilty for accusing him. That's why he's freaking out. Oh, wow! That's where the credits roll. That's not what I was expecting. Okay. Alright, so we got the crew back together. I'm shocked that they wrapped up, like, everyone getting attacked so quickly. I thought they were going to actually have them be captured and then play that out until the finale, but... Okay, now, there's suspicion that someone here is a traitor. And I am surprisingly proud of Mr. Murtaugh. Like, holy crap. He was creepy the whole time, but I knew he was a red herring. But I didn't expect him to be actually heroic in this episode. That completely caught me off guard. That's really interesting, you know, giving us the blank window instead of one of our characters staring through a window like we usually do in these episodes. The fact that I was right about the cult makes me very happy. I feel like it's a pretty obvious thing, but it just makes me happy to get the little things right sometimes on these shows. But yeah, that was an exciting episode. So Ivan's claiming Murtaugh is dead. We'll see if that's true, and like the acid splashing was meant to, like, you know, be our stand-in for Blood so that this can still be on YouTube, because we know they've done stand-ins for Blood on this show before, with like oil and stuff like that, on the two that Trinity mentioned, the realtor and the guy at the hardware store. But yeah, so we'll see if Murtaugh's actually dead. Honestly, if he is, raises the stakes even more, and what a hero's way to go out protecting Ivan. So F's in the chat for Murtaugh if he's actually dead. We'll see. But that was, like, it was mainly, like, I feel like it was mainly getting everyone back together. The big reveal of this episode was the fact that there are multiple Crowfaces. And I've been kind of suspecting that this whole time. Especially after last episode when everyone was getting hit at the same time. But they are doing such a good job of making that beaked figure such a threatening, like, imposing, you know, just silhouette that as soon as you see it, you just feel dread immediately. Like, that was really, really well done. Again, like I said, Crowface, my favorite part of this franchise at this point. So there you have it. That was my reaction to Hello Neighbor, to Welcome to Raven Brooks, Season 2, Episode 5, Deal with the Devil. And considering that Trinity didn't actually make a deal with Peterson like it was heavily implying at the end of the last episode, I'm thinking it's more implying that Peterson suggesting that there was a traitor in Trinity's friend group was actually accurate. And one of them made a deal with the devil. And I am super nervous here. Here's what I'm going to say here. I'm super nervous about this because she's my favorite character in the show. We did not see Maritza this entire episode until the very end when she met up with Enzo and they ran off to meet up with Trinity. We saw what happened to every other one of the kids in this episode. And this is a short episode. This is 11 and a half minutes. They could have put in like another minute or two of what Marissa was up to. I'm very concerned, because like I said, she's my favorite character. I'm very concerned that this is implying she's the traitor. We'll see what happens as we go forward, because I don't think it's Nikki. I think he's just going through some stuff, looking creepy in the window. My money's on Marissa right now, which I hate to say, but that's who my suspicion is on right now for someone being a traitor. And considering the next episode, which I see the premiere set up for next week, before I say that, I just want to say, actually, thank you, Tiny Build, for not dropping all three episodes on Halloween like you originally announced you were going to. This makes it so much easier for me to get this episode out quickly. But next episode right there, the premiere setup, is called Secret Neighbor. And the whole point of Secret Neighbor in the game, which is actually really cool that they're going to tie into that, considering it was almost like it felt like a very non-canon game at the time, is that one of the kids was secretly the neighbor in disguise. Now, obviously, it's not actually going to be Peterson in disguise, but I think it's implying that, like, because there's only one episode after that, it'll be the finale, is the episode title is hinting that they're gonna reveal who the traitor is next time, and that's gonna set up our big climactic finale. So, I'm looking forward to seeing this. Again, that'll be next week, and I assume episode 7, the finale, will be the week after that. And there's a bunch more content coming up, because the month of FNAF is officially over as of the last video uploaded before this. So, we are right back into the regularly scheduled programming with Meta Runner reactions, going back to Epic Mickey Rebrush and Luigi's Mansion 2, and lots more games that I've planned. And I also plan to start playing Hello Neighbor, Hide and Seek, the VR game, next month, so be sure to subscribe and stick around for that. But anyway, that's gonna do it for this video. Hope you all enjoyed it. Please drop a like or a comment down below if you did. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you all on the next one. Bye, guys!